So we've got a budget which is not an easy budget, a budget where the fiscal deficit is in fact one that is seen as pretty responsible at 3.8 for this year and 3.5 for next year. And the big number there that helps us achieve it, to my mind, is really the disinvestment and privatization number, going up as it is from 1 lakh to over 2 lakh crore. Ambitious, but a big bang announcement in terms of the LIC IPO, which helps achieve it. But my worry would be that if we do not achieve this number, it will throw the FISC totally out of gear. So the attention the government puts on execution, and I would like to see a serious restructuring of the way disinvestments are done, because to leave it to ministries is never easy, because there are lots and lots of decisions, as I found when we were doing these disinvestments in the Vajpayee era, which require some pretty brave souls to sign off. So I do hope that we can stay focused on that disinvestment privatization agenda. I think the other big area which we are seeing focus on is infrastructure, as FICCI had hoped and indeed asked for. There's a pipeline of infrastructure projects, which I take it means that they are already pretty much pre-approved. And any money that goes towards infrastructure spend is important because it kickstarts the economy. We know that it then flows to the cement sector, steel, even rural connectivity. And all of this helps the economy as we look at growth. The third area, which is, I think, important, is despite being in a pretty tough situation, there is some reprieve given to the middle-income groups in terms of tax. And that is important because it will put demand and consumption back into the system. And we will need to see that money now coming through to help consumption. And from consumption, we will see, I think, interest in investment as well. The fourth, which I'm very happy to see, is that there are schemes of government, whether it's in agriculture, water, ODF plus, SBM, all the schemes which government started are very much still squarely there. Government has not abandoned any of these, what I would call as pro-poor schemes that are very important for India to embrace in the longer term. So there hasn't been a sacrificing of the longer term for the short term. There's a desire and ability to keep all the balls in the air, and that, I think, is important also as we go forward. So all in all, in a very tough scenario, a tough balancing act, we have seen the finance minister pull this off quite well. But the dependencies, as I mentioned, on disinvestment targets are a bit worrying and will need a lot of focus.